Tartia City Expats Club is a non-profit social organisation and our speakers are volunteers. The club as such assumes no responsibility or liability for the professional reputation of or the quality of services provided by the speaker today.
G'day, Sweaty Cab. Well, today, a very dangerous interview. Renlek Sand is going to interview David S. Lee, the most famous person we've ever had walk through the doors of this club, right? But what's your Chinese name?
Li Suquan. Li Suquan. Li Suquan.
And how do you spell it?
In America, it's used as Li Suquan. L-E-S-U-C-H-A-N.
And this guy's story and the video clip, I tell you, you've got to watch it. It's probably the most charming talk. It was just charming talk about this guy's amazing life as a Chinese pop star and stuff. So just give us one highlight of what was a moment when you stood there and thought, how the hell did I get here?
It was amazing. An old lady, 80 years old. I was supposed to sign a management agreement with some company in Los Angeles. But on the day that we were supposed to sign it, I didn't sign it, I pushed it back because for some personal reason. But anyway, an 80 years old lady finally took my music to Asia to promote it. And it was a crazy, unbelievable scene. But when I stand on the stage of a rock and roll arena, and then this old lady on a wheelchair and on the front row, and she waved at me and I waved at her, and she sold her Rolex watch, the last money that she had, to buy an airline ticket to fly from Los Angeles back to Asia just to promote my music. And it changed my entire life. And her name was Gu Mama. I remember her throughout my life. And that's how the whole story started.
That's an amazing story, which, by the way, you didn't tell on stage.
Yes.
And but one of the things, you're not just having done the pop star and become a record producer and promoter, a big, huge promoter in China, carrying out bags full of US dollars, smuggling them across the border.
Yes.
But you've also been a motivational speaker and helped people get clearer about what they should do with their lives.
Yes, that's what I'm doing now. I'm 62 years old now. I think my story could help more young people and to really think through what they really want in life. If they can see what they want to be in the future, they can backtrack and to come up with a yearly plan and monthly plan. And all they have to do is carry on, execute it little by little, and they finally will reach their goal at the end.
Yeah, something I heard once, which I thought really struck me, was we overestimate what we can do in a day.
Yes.
We overestimate what we can do in a week.
That's right.
Overestimate what we can do in a month.
That's right.
Overestimate what we can do in a year.
Right.
But we underestimate what we can do in 10 years.
Oh, that's what a great statement. Yes, yes.
You talk about the five-year dream.
Right. So 5 years, a little shorter space, so you probably can see the result a little sooner. It's a little easier to pursue that goal. So that's the story that Valerie Johnson that taught me when I was back in Texas going through the school. And I made a lifetime decision to quit my job at NASA and to pursue something really wild and crazy, to go to Hollywood to become a singer. Back then, everybody would laugh at me. But, you know, life took a strange turn.
Because she said, you know, where do you want to be?
Exactly.
Where do you want to see yourself in 5 years?
Yes. So all you have to do is just take your car out of that comfortable, cozy little garage and take that first step. And then the road will start opening up in front of your eyes, little by little.
Talking about cars and roads, I met this guy on a BART bus. What the hell did we talk about?
I don't know. You were sitting on the bus, you know, there's a tutu bus. I was sitting here, you were sitting on there. I said, hey, what did you do?
That's how we started.
Yeah, now we're like mates, and he's giving talks at the club and stuff.
Yes.
So it's been a great joy knowing you.
It's a great honor. And Ren helped me with my daughter's situation, too.
Oh, yeah.
I had a major problem with my little daughter a few years back, you know, communication, parenthood.
Because they were like 17.
Yeah, they were like very rebellious. And then Ren gave me such a whole book, and it gave me a point out a few pointers, and it helped me.
I've written a book on communication.
Yes.
And one of the things, because he was obviously having trouble communicating with him as set, and I had like the 10 steps for dealing with upset people.
And I circle down with a highlight pen and I start, you know, take it one step at a time. And my daughter, you saw the result. Yeah. With my two daughters right now, we are such a great, with my daughter, great relationship.
Because
with
it's one of those things, people aren't good when other people get upset, exactly. Especially if they're your children. You think, I'm going to prove to you, you should never get upset yeah. with me, and I'm going to convince you, you should not be, and that's the worst thing you can
exactly.
do.
Exactly. So Ran with that book really helped me so much. So thank you.
You should be my publicity agent.
Yes. Okay.
All right. Well, it's just been a delight interviewing you, and the talk was one of the most delightful talks we've ever had at the club. You really want to do yourself a favor and have a listen to the talk. And he's going to come back and give us some information about China and Taiwan and okay. how to smuggle US dollars out of China and Taiwan and Russia.
Okay.
Meanwhile, it's goodbye from Ren and David and Pattaya City Expat Club.
Goodbye.